Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Ace here, and today I welcome you all back to another awesome episode of The Legend of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds Let's Play Series on my channel. Hope you guys all enjoy watching this video. If you do, be sure to punch that like button right in the face for me, as well as answer the comment question of the day, which is, what are you guys looking forward to the most in this upcoming winter season? Let me know down in the comment section below. I myself am looking forward to spending a lot of family time with my family and my siblings, and there really isn't any other feeling like watching, you know, sitting down, gathering around the living room, you know, and watching some holiday specials with your family. It really is such a nice and heartwarming feeling, and it's really awesome. So that's what I look forward to the most. That's what I am looking forward to the most this holiday season, because, you know, usually when I was a kid, it'd be all about the gifts and stuff, but now because I'm an adult, I have to purchase my own gifts, so not really too excited about spending money now, now that I'm an adult with responsibilities and stuff like that. But I'm looking forward to spending family time more than anything, so that's that. You guys can let me know your answer to the comment question of the day in the comment section down below. Last episode, we were short, I think, like 20 or so rupees from being able to purchase the smooth gem from the street merchant. So now we can do that, and also the gamer's train actually pointed out that we can actually just go ahead and merge into this wall right over here and pop out right behind the shady dude and sneak up on him right over here. Alright, who's there? Yo, where'd you come from? Yeah, I just sort of merged into the wall, you know, basic stuff. It happens all the time. Sorry. Huh? I had no idea that stone was that precious. Yeah, it's probably like, I mean, I'm pretty sure he'd still steal it either way, so yeah. I knew that gemstone would fetch a high price. Well, yeah, definitely, it was quite the high price. I don't know what kind of a voice I'm doing for him. It's been so long since I've recorded this series, I can't even remember what his voice was that I gave him. But whatever, we're gonna go with it. I'm sorry, I already sold it to that guy over there. Yeah, so he sold it to a street merchant. We can buy it now, though, because I went ahead and I collected a few rupees, so yeah, we should be good to go. I already spent all the money I got from selling that darn stone. I couldn't help taking it. My boots helped me run so fast. I've been stealing everything that isn't nailed down, but here, you take these boots. I can tell that you won't abuse their power. I hope they fit. So here we've gotten the, what are these boots called? The Pegasus boots. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Press L for a little while and you'll be able to break out into a mad dash. These boots take some getting used to, but you'll figure it out. Alright, let's see. Also, oh, do we have to like charge it up? Oh wow. Oh wait, once we're charged, can we just like move it anywhere we want? How does this work exactly? Are we able? Okay, we're not able to control. Link just goes on a wild running spree. Alright, that's hilarious. Alright, anyway, we have to purchase the gem from this street merchant over here.
Yes, the gemstone of remarkable quality, smooth as silk. And for you, only 200 rupees. Interested, my friend?
Why, yes I am, and there goes our entire life savings. You know, all those times working in the blacksmith's workshop, doing all those smelting and all that stuff, and there it is. Life savings down the drain, all to purchase a smooth gem for the sake of the Queen Zora, or whatever her name was. Actually, I think we are able to fly right over there if we just go ahead and call the witch lady person thing that was, that wanted to help us out. So where is this Eastern Palace? Witch's House. Let's go right over there because that's a bit closer to Zora's domain. Irene, that's what her name was.
Ever confused about where to go next? My gram isn't big on it, but I swear by fortune telling, had yours done, it works, really. So stop by the fortune teller near the forest.
So yeah, the fortune teller by the forest is, I believe, Irene's grandmother. Then again, I'm not too sure, but whatever, here we are. And we just go ahead and merge into this wall and pop out the other side. There we go. And hey, where'd that, I did not want to do that, but where'd that other Zora guy go? Wait, are you telling me we can just... Oh, okay, because I thought we could just jump over. What? Why is it that I'm able to jump from one side to the other, but I can't jump? Why can't I do it vice versa? That makes no sense. Why do I keep jumping off? Oh my gosh, I need to recalibrate this control stick. It's been bugging me for days. I'm just too lazy to do it. Alright, I do not want to get attacked by those pesky birds. Let's continue heading up over here. Alright, I need some hearts. I need some hearts. I've only got two right now. It's not looking too good for us. Alright, there we go. We're good, we're good, we're good, we're good, we're good, we're good. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot that thing. Maybe we can get another heart or something. No? Alright then, whatever. I'm gonna drop down here. And let's rush past these guys. There we go. This is Zora's Domain, or whatever this place is called. I'm just gonna call it Zora's Domain, because that's what it's called in Ocarina of Time. So I think, did we just talk to him? White stranger, do you have the Queen Smooth's gem? Why, yes, yes I do. Throw it in the pool, hurry! Alright, so, yeah, do you want to throw the smooth gem into the pool? Well, I don't really want it. I'm regretfully throwing it into the pool, because I just spent 200 rupees on that. That's my entire life savings, you know? I was gonna buy lots of candy with that, but no. I had to waste it on a lousy smooth gem, which we don't even get to keep, because we have to return it to this Princess or Queen Zora thing. Yeah, it's the Queen. The Queen! The bloating has stopped! Well, you think? I mean, look at that. She's a lot skinnier now, so, yeah. Are you the one who... Okay, she has a feminine voice, of course. Not a super deep voice.
Thanks to you, I'm free of my pool. That was all rather undignified. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Orin, Queen of the Zoras.
Alright,
I don't know how I came to rely on that troublesome smooth gem, but I do need it, so I thank you deeply. I'm filled with gratitude. Please take these, won't you?
What exactly is she gonna give to us right now? What are these things? Ooh, Zora's flippers. Time to jump in with both feet. Press A to dive and press B to swim faster. So I believe we will actually be able to swim now using these Zora's flippers.
They will allow you to swim and dive, so you may travel the rivers and roam the lakes. But my Zoras do consider that their territory, and while I tell them to get along with people, I have to admit, they just don't listen. So be careful out there.
Oh, okay, so are you telling me that we are allowed to swim around in the rivers and lakes, but your people might attack me? Even though I just saved your life, basically? Okay, alright. That's a great way to repay the hero who, you know, returned your smooth gem at a cost of 200 rupees. Yeah, Queen Orin, you might wanna send out an order saying, you know, lay off the kid in the green hat or something like that, I don't know. Anyway, guys, we can just go back to, where should we go? I think, hold on, can we just go back to our house? Yeah, I think we can just go back to our house, because I think that's the fastest way to get back down to, what was it, the House of Gale? Is that where we're going to? I believe so. Alright, there we go, we're just gonna go ahead and fly off back to our house, and, we can just go straight over to, the lake thing right over here. Alright, there we go. And from here on out, I believe we should actually be able to swim across this lake in order to get access to the House of Gale. So, oh wait, we can just land in the water. Okay, that's so cool. Well, and if we press B, we can actually swim faster. That is cool. Wait. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. I like it. What's it? Oh, wait, that thing can attack me while I'm in water, can it? Okay, no. How do I get it? How exactly do I get up here? Hold on, maybe I have to go like this way. I'm not too sure. Oh, that's a Zora thing. Okay, there we go. We can just swim up over here. And when was the last time the Zoras could? What is this? Oh, do we need? Are you serious? We actually need another item. Okay, well, at least we will be able to fly back here, so, that's cool. A new weather vane has been added. Yes, I will save my progress. And, another thing, guys, if you're still watching a video, let me know how the audio quality sounds of this video, like how my mic audio sounds, because I am using a different mic. I'm using my headset mic as, despite the fact that, you know, I have an actual mic. The reason why is because I don't want my actual mic to get broken, because it is quite expensive, and my siblings come into my room, like, quite often, and I'm always, like, worried and, cautious, like, not cautious, I'm always, like, scared that they might, you know, come into my room and accidentally break it, because it is a really, really expensive mic, and it's a good mic, but, the audio quality of this video should be a bit less than usual, but it shouldn't be that much of a noticeable difference, especially if you guys are just using, you know, headphones, like the, Apple earbuds, then you guys probably shouldn't be able to hear any sort of difference, but, It should be alright, I don't know.
Welcome back.
Hi there, Ravio, you gonna give us some, stuff, yo?
I still haven't found anywhere else to stay, so I spruced things up in here.
Oh, that's right, yeah, oh my gosh, he made a shop in our house. What? Okay, well, what was the thing that we really needed? What was the item that we needed again? I think it was, hold on a second.
So, I take it things didn't go as planned, but the item I lent you came in handy, right? You know, there's actually plenty more where that came from. Ravio is all about helping heroes.
Yeah, I can totally see that, man. Thank you, Ravio, for, you know, hooking us up with lots of awesome gear. Are we able to collect all of these gears? I don't know. You know what they say? You wash my ears, I'll wash your... No, it's I'll scratch your back, you scratch mine. Where did the whole ear thing come from? I get it, it's because he has long ears. I get it, Ravio, the raccoon bunny rabbit thing. Alright, anyway.
Alrighty then, here's how my shop works. I rent a wide range of items and weapons to you, and the rental period, that's the best part. You keep the rentals for a long time. Specifically, until the next time you fall in battle, which might never happen, right? Sure, you look tough. But if you do fall in battle, my pal Shiro here will swoop in to collect my property.
Alright, so that is what that little winged creature is all about. I've been wondering the longest time what that thing had to do with any of the story or what that thing had to do with Ravio. I thought he was just a little pet that Ravio kept around, but I don't know.
Right, just like that, swoop right in. Collect my stuff while you, just lie there. So, see anything you want? I've got plenty of gear besides the bow. If you find anything you like, just walk up to it and press A.
So, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, we actually need one of these things. No, not the hookshot, not the hookshot. No, one of these things right over here. I believe so. You interested in the tornado rod? Yes, I do. The rental price is 20. What, we have to pay up for this? Well, you know what? I guess, why not? We'll rent the hookshot for 20 rupees. Make sure, or not the hookshot, what am I saying? The tornado rod. Make sure you take good care of my tornado rod, alright? Yada, yada, yada. Alright. Ravio says, see you next time. I love how he just set up a business in our freaking house. How does that? Only raccoon rabbits would do that. Anyway, let's go ahead, fly back to the House of Gales and see if that is exactly the item that we need in order to actually enter the House of Gales. If it isn't, then unfortunately we have to fly back over to Ravio's and do some other stuff. Yeah, I believe we do need a tornado rod. Let's just go ahead and replace the tornado rod with the bow and arrow. There we go. And what exactly? Whoa. Okay. That's weird. Hold on. What if we use it over here? Wait, are we able to, like, fly around with it? No, we just, like, okay, we just get propelled upwards. That's it. We can't move while we're being propelled upwards, I guess. So this is it, the House of Gale. Alright, that's interesting. Oh, okay, so we are actually only able to propel ourselves upwards, but we can just go ahead and ride these air current channels or something like that and, you know, move from platform to platform. Okay, guys, so this is going to be it for this episode of the Let's Play. I know it was quite the short episode, but this is going to be it for this episode. It was mainly just a test video so that I could, you know, just get the settings with my headset mic just so that, you know, everything works and just to, you know, get some feedback on it and see if you guys, you know, notice anything different in the audio. If you don't notice anything different in the audio, that's absolutely perfect for me and pretty much perfect for you guys because it won't sound bad. So, yeah, that's basically it for this video. Hopefully you guys all enjoyed watching. If you did, be sure to smack that like button right in the face for me. And as always, till the next video, eat some muffins and take it easy, guys. Peace. Bye. See ya.